YouTube Isaac going the Goat House is back after a crazy week 10 in the NFL, heading into week 11 here with my updated NFL power rankings. Do this video every single week, and since it was a crazy week, there's a lot of crazy changes within these power rankings, so we'll go through these in just a second. Right before we get started, we have extra content available on the Patreon, patreon.com/thegoathouse. If you want playoff predictions updated every week, every Tuesday, score predictions updated every week for every game, and 2020 NFL mock drafts updated every single week with the updated order, all that is part of one package deal on our Patreon. There's a link in the description. Check it out for more info, and please help us get to that subscriber goal of 40K by the end of the year. We'd really appreciate it. Full NFL content, recaps, power rankings, predictions. We got college football content as well. In the offseason, we cover free agency and the NFL draft fully. So subscribe, click that like button, check us out on Twitter, always tweeting during live games. The Seahawks Niners game was crazy. And that will shake some things up in this week's power rankings. And before we get started, a reminder that I say every single week, you can't base things off head to head. You can't compare two teams, four teams, 10 teams, 32 teams compared to each other. And you can't focus on one team, whether they moved up or down. It's not only because what they did in that week matters, what's going on around them. Record doesn't matter as much anymore because we have identities on team. You know, it mattered quite a bit when teams were undefeated. No more undefeated teams left. So record does matter, but not as much as, you know, some people think. But starting at the bottom, Cincinnati Bengals remain at 32. They're in the driver's seat for the first overall pick for Joe Burrow or Tua, whoever it may be. They remain at 32, so no surprise there. The Redskins actually moved down two spots for not even playing. They moved down to 31. It's just because teams ahead of them that had one loss, obviously quite a bit of them won this week. So they're moving up a bit. So the Redskins moved down. They have a chance to move up a little bit playing the Jets this week. The Giants moved down three spots. It's been an unfortunate season so far. You know, it looked like they had some life right when Daniel Jones came in, and it's really falling apart. The Jets game's a game we expect them to win. They couldn't pull it off, even though it was somewhat of a good game. They're down to number 30. The Jets are up two spots to number 29, beating a Giants team. Somewhat impressive, you know, for since they're battling a team and they're in their area there, and they'll move up two spots because of it. The Dolphins won another one, but they're still going to remain at 28. Impressive win. You know, they did play Brian Hoyer, but didn't move up because I thought the Falcons beating the Saints, that's a good enough win to move them up ahead of the Dolphins and up three spots to number 27. And the Falcons, you know, maybe the coaching changes, maybe that changed something. Maybe that gets them back on track. They got a lot of work to do to make it a decent season still. So we'll see. But that was an impressive win. Down four spots is the Arizona Cardinals, and it's tough with the Cardinals because I think they've been getting better. You know, the offense has been impressive, and Kyler Murray has been impressive, you know, very impressive. It's a bright future there in Arizona. And, you know, I think they're probably better when it's all said and done, the 26th best team, but based on what's going on around them and them, you know, getting going on this losing skid here, they're down to 26, unfortunately. Only up one spot coming off a win is the Browns. It's a pretty good win against the Bills in terms of beating a team that, you know, that's a lot better than you, I guess, right now, but not really a good win in terms of what went down in the field. It was a game that they should be a little more comfortable in once you're seeing what's going on in this game, and it was pretty sloppy. But at the end of the day, they got the win. Just couldn't move them up a whole bunch. You know, that Broncos loss a week ago still stings a little bit, you know, for the Browns. I couldn't move them up a whole bunch. The Broncos moved down a spot. They did not play. Teams moved up ahead of them just because they won, just because what was going on. So nothing the Broncos did there. You know, they got a tough one against the Vikings this week. We'll see what they can do. Moving up two spots is the Bucs. They got a good win against the Cardinals. They break that losing streak, so that's a good thing. Couldn't move them a whole bunch. Can't move them up too much because, you know, it seems like every time you do, they lose. But, yeah, we'll see them stay consistent now. You know, they're a pretty talented team. You know, I think when it's all said and done, they probably could be better than 23 as well. They just went on a bad losing streak. The Bears move up two spots. They're at 22. Not the most impressive win. You know, Jeff Driscoll in there for the Lions. You know, the Bears, you know, maybe gained some momentum. You know, Trubisky looked somewhat impressive compared to the rest of the season, the early parts of the season. They move up two spots with a win. We'll need to do a little more, though, to impress me. 21's the Lions. The Lions, it's a tough one because their record's pretty bad, but their record doesn't show, how good this team is. They're better than this. They're better than 21, but they had to go down two spots because what's going on. Couldn't move them down a whole bunch just because what's going on, too, though. You can't take too much away from a Jeff Driskel game, and you still got those games they very easily could have won. So it's a tough situation with the Lions. Hopefully Stafford gets healthy and they can get back on track. They're at 21. Staying at 20, no movements. The Jags, they did not play. Nick Foles is going to be back. We'll see how that changes things. But for right now, they stay put at 20. Moving down two spots is the Chargers. Tough loss to the Raiders. Interesting game, close game. They definitely had a realistic shot to win it. Looking at how the two teams played, there was some really good spots for the Chargers. You look on the defensive side, some guys stepped up at some points. Melvin Gordon stepped up. But really looking at the two teams, how they played, I thought the Raiders really, they did definitely outplayed them in that game. They moved down two spots. I still think the Chargers can get some things going, but it's been a tough season. Moving down five spots, talking about a tough season, a rough season so far, as the Rams. A game they should win. We saw them struggle early in the year, and they got a real good break. Who they were playing. They were playing the Bengals and the Falcons, and they had the bye week, and then a tough loss to the Steelers. A game that you expect them to win. Just not enough offense, not enough offensive line. Goff is not doing well under pressure. The play calling. The play calling I don't like. The system I still like, but it's the same exact as last year. Teams are figuring it out. The defense actually steps up. So that's kind of a punch in the gut for many Rams fans. It kind of seems, I'm a Vikings fan, it kind of feels like the same thing. The offense and the defense can never be on the same page. It's one or the other. You finally got the defense balling, and it would be the opposite for the Vikings, but you finally got the defense balling, and the offense can't do their thing that they were doing last year, so it's got to hurt a little bit. So maybe they can figure it out. There's still hope there. Moving up four spots, inconsistent team, but the Tennessee Titans, they could be a team. They do have a bye week this week, but they could be a team that could continue to be on the rise, even though they've been inconsistent this year, because that's a big-time win against the Chiefs, but it is a season changer or momentum changer. So could we possibly see them move up as the year goes on? But it is a tough schedule, but that was a big-time win for them. They're up four spots. That big of a win, almost feel like they should move up a little more, but it's tough to put them ahead of the teams, that are ahead of them right now in the top 16. In the top 10, we have a hidden movement, so we'll reveal those when we get there. Moving down five spots, number 16 is the Bills. They may have a better record than some of the teams, slightly a better record, some of the teams that will be ahead of them. Doesn't matter too much for me when you have an identity on the team. The Bills, just not enough offense. We just talked about the Titans. I think they're very similar to a team like the Titans. It's just pretty good defense, just not enough offense. The Titans, kind of flipped their identity in that Chiefs game. That's kind of what will happen in the Chiefs when you play the Chiefs. But similar teams there. The Bills, I just don't have full trust in their offense. It'll get better. You hope it gets better over time because they got a young quarterback, a young team. But the defense looks good. It's a game they got to win against the Browns. It is a game they have to win. Disappointing there. They fall to 16. Staying put with their bye week at 15 is the Philadelphia Eagles. See, the bye week, I could see it. The bye week kind of turning things around. It's a team that has talent. It's a team that definitely can turn around. Tough game against the New England Patriots this week. We got some weird movement or non-movement coming up, but it's not really because of what the team did. It's because of what teams did around them, so keep that in mind. The Panthers did lose. It was a pretty good game against the Packers, so you can't deduct points, I guess, is a good way to put it, because of that game. But really, who's going to move ahead of them? The Eagles on a bye week? No. The Bills just lost. The Titans, I can't move them up enough. And you see teams like the Rams, the Chargers, the Lions, those teams lost. So no one is, going to move ahead of them. Besides, obviously, maybe a team or two. Who knows what we got coming up here. But, the Panthers remain at 14. It's a good team. Kyle Allen's getting better. I see good things in that kid's future, real good things. That Niners loss still hurts a little bit, when talking about the Panthers, giving up 51 points. So it's kind of a team I'm kind of back and forth on. They end up staying the same. Moving on one spot, it's the Cowboys. Tough to figure out what to do with the Cowboys, too, because they play a pretty good team in the Vikings, but at the same time, it's a game they should win. It's prime time. They're home. The Vikings are missing, all kinds of players. It's a game they should win, But I only have them moving down one spot is because I'm actually kind of still impressed with this Cowboys team. Dak is very impressive. Obviously, their offensive line is very solid. I like what they're doing on third down. You know, that they have the best success rate on third down, and it showed in that game against the Vikings. And that goes a long way. You know, that'll continue to pop up and be good down the stretch of the season. So I'm gonna keep them around that range. You know, I move them way down, only move them down one spot. You know, mainly because I still think it's somewhat of a impressive team. Somewhat, they do need to get Zeke going. But mainly because, kind of like what I said about the Panthers. I mean, who's really gonna move ahead of them right now? The Panthers just lost. The Eagles had a bye. The Bills just lost to the Browns. So I mean, you can't move them down too much. Moving up six spots is Pittsburgh Steelers right here. You know, it's weird to see the Steelers at number 12, and these aren't end of the year predictions. Sometimes people get that confused. I have no clue why some of you get that confused, but you know, when it's all said and done, do I think the Steelers will be the 12th best team in football? I don't. You know, they're on a 4-game winning streak right now. The defense is looking lights out, so who knows? But again, they're on a 4-game winning streak. They're winning. They upset the Rams. Defense is unbelievable right now. They definitely deserve to move up six spots. They definitely deserve here going into week 11 to be number 12 in the power rankings. They definitely do. So that's where I put them. Moving down three spots is the Colts. Colts are another tough team to deal with because they played the Steelers a week ago. Brissett gets hurt, ends up being a close game. You would think Brissett's in, they win the game. Same thing with the Dolphins. You would think Brissett's in, they win the game. I'm pretty confident in those, but it's kind of assuming things, and it's a game against the Dolphins is a game they should win regardless who their quarterback is. So you definitely have to move them down. I just can't move them down a whole bunch, because I do think they're better than the teams that are right below them. Very close. Those teams are kind of in the same area. So they have to move down. You know, last week I kind of gave them somewhat of a pass. I think I moved them down one spot. But, you know, a game that I probably would have moved them down more for losing the Dolphins. But, again, you know, I don't know if I can quite move the Steelers up that much. And it's not like you can move the Cowboys, the Panthers up, you know, for losing when they were already below the Colts. So, it's a tough situation. Coming out at number 10, the Raiders. The Raiders are at number 10 in kind of a similar situation with the Steelers. When it's all said and done, am I predicting the Raiders to be the 10th best team in football? I think, actually, they could be, really. You know, if I had to put money on it, maybe not. But these aren't predictions. Week 11, power rankings, they're looking good. That offense is looking real good. The offensive line's getting better. Derek Carr's getting better. Josh Jacobs getting better. The play calling's getting better. The defense even stepped up. Looks like it's getting better. You know, Cleveland Farrell, Max Crosby, those guys are getting better. They're feeling it. Even the games they recently lost, you know, look at the Texans. They held their own there. You know, they could have won those types of games. So they're up six spots. They're number 10. Impressed with this Raiders team. I want to see more on defense. You know, I want to see them going against maybe a little better competition, but, you know, they don't make the schedule. It's not really their fault. It's not like it was the easiest thing. They played some tough teams. You know, they beat the Bears when we thought the Bears were good. They had to play the Packers, the Texans. So I don't want to hear anything about their schedule. So they're number 10, up six spots. Very impressive team. And this is where it may get a little weird for some people. The Chiefs remain at number 9. They do not move down. They lost to the Titans, a game they should win. At the same time, a lot of guys are hurt coming out of the game. They already have offensive linemen not starting the game. Crazy amount of injuries. Patrick Mahomes' first game back. With all that, I still thought they should have won the game. You expect them to win the game, but I just can't move them down. They're a very good team, but you can't move the Raiders up seven spots. There's no way the Colts should be ahead of them right now. The Steelers, you can't move them up that many spots. The Cowboys just lost. The Panthers, I'm repeating myself a lot with a lot of these teams, but you get my point. It's not what the Chiefs did. Obviously, they lost. Obviously, it's not it's a pretty bad loss, but just what's going on around them, and they're coming off a good win against the Vikings, don't forget, too. What's going on around them, you can't really move them down. If you want to move the Raiders ahead, up seven spots, I'm not going to argue too much. Six spots is enough for me. But they're at number 9. Number 8 coming off their bye is the Texans. They're moving down one spot. Obviously not what they did. They were on a bye. It's just, you know, one team that's ahead of them forced them to move down. So that's all there is to that. I'm excited to see this Texans team play the Ravens. Excited about the Texans offense. It seems like, you know, Carlos Hyde is starting to get going. That was kind of their flaw, their run game. You know, what I am, you know, a little concerned about is having no J.J. Watt down the stretch. So we'll see how this team is. Been a big fan of Deshaun Watson, what that team's doing this year. Moving up to number 7 is the Minnesota Vikings. They're up 3 spots. Had to move them ahead of the Texans. And very impressive win, against the Cowboys. Primetime in Dallas, Sunday Night Football. You're missing Adam Thielen. You're missing Linval Joseph and Trey Waynes. Out of the three, I thought Trey Waynes was like the least impactful, but it ended up being kind of the most. But really can kind of go back to Thielen. If Thielen's in that game, I think they win that game pretty easy because less stress on Diggs, less stress on pretty much everybody else, Kirk Cousins including him. So that is very impressive that they went there and won that game. They made it a little close, too close at times. It got me a little scared as a fan. But that's an impressive win. They definitely deserve to move up 3 spots. That Chiefs loss still hurts, though, because that was a game they should have won in multiple different ways. That one is hurting right now. But number 6 is the Saints, moving down 4 spots. Moving down a lot for a team in the top tier here. But if you lose to the Falcons and lose to the Falcons in that fashion with other teams, battling and winning, you're going to move down 4 spots. You can't move down any more than that. There was no consideration moving them down any more than 4 spots. But that's where they had to move down right now. You could debate, 5-6, the Saints and who I have ahead of them. But you lost while some other teams had some big wins. And, other teams only have one loss that, at the same time, I feel pretty good about those teams. They had to move down 4 spots for me. It's a concerning loss, Everybody has just those weeks, and they're coming off the bye week, and sometimes the bye week works in a negative way. I almost see it working more in a negative way than in a positive way. People always think a bye week's a positive thing. I guess some of these teams with byes still yet to come, and they're beat up. I guess that's a good thing. But hopefully it didn't work in a negative way long term. They do have, I actually consider the Buccaneers game coming up a tough game for them. It's going to be a tough one. We'll see if Marshawn Lattimore plays. That's pretty tough. We'll see if they can open some things up downfield because they definitely could not against the Falcons. But down 4 spots, that's tough. But, they're definitely in conversation when it's all said and done for the best team in football. They really are. Number 5 is the Green Bay Packers moving up 1 spot. So that's what I was saying. The debate in my head was Packers-Saints. Do I move the Saints down 3 spots to 5? It's a week-by-week power ranking. The Saints just came off a very bad loss to the Falcons. The Packers just beat a pretty solid team in the Panthers in a good game. Packers got to move up. Once I really thought that, it really wasn't too much of a question. The Packers got to move up. You could argue the Packers had a scary situation where, it makes you think if this can happen again, that being against the Chargers, and that's kind of a bad loss. But you can kind of compare the two. Lost to the Chargers, lost to the Falcons, and I'm kind of living in the now right now. The Packers coming off the win, so you kind of compare those in that way. No question, I thought the Packers should be number 5, and now we're into the top 4, and this is where it gets real tough. The whole power rank has been tough after a weird week. Number 4 is the Patriots, no movement there, coming off a tough loss to the Ravens. Ravens are a good team, and then they're off the bye week though as well, so no movement here. They stay at 4 for me. Want to see, very good team. When it's all said and done, they can be the best team in football. They can win the Super Bowl. I want to see them stop the run a little better. I want to see them protect Big Tom a little better. Number 3, former number 1, is the San Francisco 49ers, down 2 spots. This gets real tough here because they were undefeated. And like I said, record hasn't really been mattering as we got to like the midway point because we got identities on the team. But when you're undefeated, you're on a different level because it's tough to win any week in the NFL. And they moved down 2 spots now. It's tough. I know they had some injuries build up, before the game and then in the game. That's tough. They went to OT with a very good team in the Seahawks and had chances to win. They lost. At the end of the day, they did lose. But, I know people will be like, you move the Niners down 2 spots for that game with injuries. It's not what's happening here. It's mainly, they did lose. On top of the two teams ahead of them, what they're doing right now. And then we'll reveal that Seahawks moving up 3 spots to number 2. And that means the Baltimore Ravens are my number 1 team in football here heading into week 11, up 2 spots. Seahawks up 3 spots. So you kind of compare there. Well, the Ravens actually just beat the Seahawks a couple weeks ago. Like I said, I don't really go head-to-head, but when it's pretty close, I guess you could. But the Ravens are the hottest team in football. Both sides of the ball, you can argue. Both sides of the ball. It's a team that is improving every single day. It's extremely impressive, and they have that big win over the Patriots. They have the big win over the Seahawks. I know they just played the Bengals. It was a pretty impressive performance anyways, but it's not just the Bengals game. You know, people may say, I'm kind of used to what everyone says in the comments. People may say, you move them up to one because they just beat the Bengals. It doesn't work like that. You know, you got moving pieces behind them, around them, and you kind of factors in their body of work. Patriots win, Seahawks win. The Ravens are at number one. No question, no doubt. No doubt in my mind, Ravens number one. Did not think about that one too much. Seahawks, Niners, Patriots, kind of in the same boat. Seahawks just beat the Niners. They're kind of getting hot. They're a very good team. They got the best player in football. You can argue that. They make clutch plays, and it's a week-by-week power ranking. They're coming off a win. The Niners come off the loss. I don't really care the fashion of the game, who's hurt, and keep in mind Tyler Lockett did get hurt in this for the Seahawks too. And I kind of talk about that game. That was a wild game. That was an absolutely wild game. Credit to both teams. That Niners defense, that pass rush is nasty. They know how to get turnovers, and the teams that just get turnovers like that continue to do that throughout the season and couldn't come up clutch down the stretch. They need to stay healthy. I actually did think the team who played, I'm not going to say who's better when it's all said and done at the end of the year at all, but I think the Seahawks played better overall in that game, if I'm being quite honest. So, but not by much. It was very close. It was a good game. So the Seahawks up to 2, Niners 3, no question Ravens are 1. We'll see what the Patriots can do against the Eagles. You know, they possibly can make their way up. It's very interesting. So like I said, it's Ravens in their own category right now to me. Then you got the Seahawks, Niners, and Patriots in the next group. And then you got the Packers and the Saints in the next group. And then you got Vikings, Texans, probably the next one. And then the other teams can pretty much, a long list of teams can make their way up and down based off what they do this next week and next few weeks. So it should be very interesting. Very, really looking forward to the Texans-Ravens game, among others. So I'm pretty excited going forward here. It's getting crazy. We're getting some big-time games. You know, that Niners-Seahawks game was wild. But there's our power rankings, doing this every single week. Also got our straight-up picks on Tuesday nights with the other members of the Goat House. Very fun video. I got my score predictions every single Wednesday. Junior has his score predictions on the Patreon. All kinds of videos. More where that came from. More on the channel. Full coverage all year long in the NFL. So please subscribe. Help us get to that 40K goal. We'd really appreciate it. That's going to do it for this one, though. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Goodbye.